we now discuss the solution of a problem from the section analysis, and the problem is based on the concept of uniform continuity of functions. This question has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 16th February 2022. And it is from the section B. The problem is, let F and G be two functions defined from the set of real numbers into itself, defined by f of x is equal to x square, g of x is equal to sine x. Which of the following functions are uniformly continuous on R? We are given four options. Option 1, h of x is equal to g of f of x. Option 2, h of x is equal to g of x multiplied by f of x. Option 3, h of x is equal to f of g of x, g of x. Option 4, h of x is equal to f of x plus g of x. We are given two functions defined from the set of real numbers into itself. And the functions are f of x is equal to x square, g of x is equal to sine x. And the four options are given below, and which of the following functions are uniformly continuous? That is the question, and we have to decide which of these four are uniformly continuous. We discuss the problem in detail. Let fg be functions from the set of real numbers to itself, and they are defined by f of x is equal to x square and g of x is equal to sine x. And we have to decide which of the following are uniformly continuous on R. And we first take the option 3, that is h of x is equal to f of g of x. And that implies h of x is equal to f of g of x. G of x is sine x. And f of sine x is sine square x. Now, h prime x, that is, take the derivative, that is 2 sine x cos x, and that is sine 2x, true for all x belongs to R. And we see now modulus of h prime x, that is equal to modulus of sine 2x, is less than or equal to 1 for all x belongs to R, meaning that it h prime x is bounded on R. So thus h of x is equal to sine square x, and it is differentiable on the whole of the real number line and has bounded derivative. The derivative is bounded on R. And we recall a result. Let I be an interval on R, and if f is a function from the interval I to R, that is, f is a real valued function defined on the interval I, and it is differentiable on I and has bounded derivative on I, then f is uniformly continuous on I. And using this result, by the above theorem, h of x is equal to f of g of x, that is equal to sine square x, is uniformly continuous on R. So therefore, the option 3, that h of x is equal to f of g of x, is uniformly continuous on R, and our answer is on option 3. Our answer is option 3, and that is the discussion about that problem. But we will rule out the other possibilities in the subsequent slides. We go to the next slide now. And we take now option 4. H of x is equal to f of x plus g of x. So that is h of x is equal to f of x is x square, g of x is sine x. We assume that h of x, that is x square plus sine x, is uniformly continuous. And it is a very well known fact that sine x is uniformly continuous on whole R. And we also know that the sum of two uniformly continuous functions is again a uniformly continuous. So therefore, h of x plus minus sine of sine x, that is equal to x square plus sine x plus minus sine x, that is equal to x square, is uniformly continuous on R, which is not true. It's a contradiction to the fact that x square is not uniformly continuous on R. On whole of R, it is not uniformly continuous. And hence, h of x is equal to x square plus sine x is not uniformly continuous. Therefore, our option 4 is not true. And we consider the option 1, that is h of x is equal to g of f of x, and that is equal to g of x square, that is equal to sine x square. We will now show that it is not uniformly continuous using the sequential criteria for uniform continuity. We recall the sequential criteria for uniform continuity. A function f, f is a real valued function defined on a set A, and that is uniformly continuous on A, where A is a subset of R, if and only if the sequence f of xn minus f of yn converges to 0 whenever the sequence xn and yn in A are such that the difference xn minus yn, the sequence, converges to 0. That is, whenever the this sequence xn minus yn converges to 0, then f of xn minus f of yn also converges to 0. And this is an if and only if statement, and we will use this now. Let xn and yn be sequences in R, where xn is under the square root of n pi by 2, and yn, y suffix n, is under the square root of n plus 1 pi by 2, where n is a natural number. Note that mod of xn minus yn, that is root pi by 2, we have taken out, root pi by 2 into modulus of root n plus root of n plus 1 tends to 0 as n tends to infinity. And why it tends to 0 as n tends to infinity? Let us see. Mod of square root of n minus square root of n plus 1 is equal to rationalizing the numerator. And that is equal to multiply and divide by root n plus root of n plus 1. And then you will get 1 by root of n plus root of n plus 1, which tends to 0 as n tends to infinity. So that's xn minus yn tends to 0 as n tends to infinity, whereas modulus of f of xn minus f of yn, that is modulus of f of xn is n pi by sine n pi by 2 minus sine yn, that is n plus 1 pi by 2. And if one of them is 1, the other is 0. So this will be plus or minus 1, modulus of that is 1, and it tends to 1 as n tends to infinity. So it is not tending to 0 as n tends to infinity. And using the sequential criteria for uniform continuity, is the h of x is equal to g of f x, and that is g of x square, that is sine x square, is not uniformly continuous. By using the sequential criteria for uniform continuity, h of x is equal to g of f of x is equal to sine x square is not uniformly continuous, and hence our option 1 is not true. Let's move to the next slide. We go for the option 2, h of x is equal to the multiplication g of x, the function, multiplied by f of x, and that is x square sine x. Now, we will show that it is not uniformly continuous using the elementary definition. So assume that h of x is equal to x square sine x is uniformly continuous. And recall the uniform continuity. A function f from A to R is uniformly continuous on a set A contained in R if given an epsilon greater than 0, there is a delta greater than 0 such that whenever xy belongs to A and modulus of x minus y is less than delta, that will imply mod of f of x minus f of y is less than epsilon. This is a very well known definition for us. So we use this. And given epsilon greater than 0, there exists a delta greater than 0 such that whenever xy belongs to A and modulus of x minus y less than delta, we have mod of fx minus fy less than epsilon. Let us take x is equal to 2n pi plus delta y2 and y is equal to 2n pi, n belongs to n. Agreed. Then modulus of x minus y is equal to delta by 2. Yeah, the difference is delta by 2, which is less than delta for all n belongs to n. And mod of fx minus fy is equal to mod of fx, f of x, f of x means 2n pi plus delta by 2 whole square into sine of 2n pi plus delta by 2 minus f of y, and y is 2n pi, so 2n pi whole square into sine of 2n pi. And sine of 2n pi is 0, and that will be modulus of 2n pi plus delta by 2 whole square multiplied by sine delta by 2, and this is a square, it's a positive thing, and sine is also positive for smaller values of delta. So, and delta is positive, we have taken, and delta greater than 0. So, this is the one what we get, and this is less than epsilon for all n belongs to n, which is not true. Why? Because epsilon is a given fixed quantity, whereas the n is increasing. N belongs to n, n will be growing, and epsilon is fixed, and this is not possible. So this is not possible since epsilon is fixed and n is growing, and hence the result. So therefore, this is also not uniformly continuous. That is, h of x is equal to g of x into f of x is also not uniformly continuous. And hence, our option is option 3, as we have discussed earlier. That is the discussion of the solution of the problem from the section analysis. And the problem is based on uniform continuity. I hope that you have understood the solution of this problem, and I wish you all the best. Thank you.